Welcome to the Math 1 lesson summary video for the task What Comes Next, What Comes Later. This is a practice understanding task, so the purpose of this task is for us to get practice identifying whether secants are arithmetic or geometric and then writing explicit and recursive rules for the sequence. So for each of the following tables that we're given, we want to describe how to find the next term in the sequence, write a recursive rule for the function, describe how the features identified in the recursive rule can be used to write an explicit rule, and then write an explicit rule, and also identify if the function is arithmetic, geometric, or neither. So I'm going to do four examples from this task to help you get the idea, and then you should be able to do the others. So starting off with function B, so we have negative 8 going down to negative 17, going down to negative 26, going down to negative 35. So when I look at that, I think of a possible constant rate of change. So let's just see, from negative 8 down to negative 17, that's subtracting 9. And then from negative 17 down to negative 26, also subtracting 9. And so on and so on. You can see subtracting 9 works every time. So for question 6, how to find the next term, we can just see that we want to subtract 9 every time. So because we have a constant difference, that makes this an arithmetic sequence. And now we can write a recursive rule. I'm going to use MVP notation. So f of n equals f of n minus 1 minus 9, starting from f of 1 equals negative 8. So to find the nth term, we're starting from negative 8, and then we're subtracting 9 a whole bunch of times. And so the question is it n times or is it n minus 1 times that we're subtracting 9? And so if we remember what we've learned, when the table starts at 1 instead of 0, that means we're subtracting or adding the common difference n minus 1 times to account for that. And so you can see that at slot 4, for example, I started at negative 8 and I subtracted 9 1, 2, 3 times, which is 1 less than 4. And that's why we put n minus 1 times. So then we can use that to write an explicit rule. F of n equals negative 8 minus 9 times n minus 1. And that takes care of that example. So now if we look at function E, it helps me to rewrite all of these as improper fractions. So since the denominator is 5, 1 would be 5 fifths, and then we would have 8 fifths, and then 11 fifths, 14 fifths, 17 fifths, and 20 fifths. And so to me, that makes it much easier to see what's happening here as we go from one term to the next. So I can see by looking at the numerators that 3 is being added every time, and that's pretty clear and easy to see, hopefully. But since there's a denominator to the fraction, instead of just saying adding 3, I need to say that we're adding 3 fifths. But this is still an arithmetic situation because we have a constant difference of 3 fifths. So we can write a recursive rule. I'm going to use more North Carolina style notation this time. So x sub n equals x sub n minus 1 plus 3 fifths. And that's starting from x sub 0 being 1. So notice this time we did start at 0. So when we describe how to find the nth term, so we're starting at 1, and then we're adding 3 fifths just n times. Let me make that a little more clear. So n times, because we started at 0. So again, you can see that if I start at, let me use a different color here, if I start at 4, so I've added 3 fifths, one time here, 2 times here, 3 times here, and 4 times here, which matches up with n being 4. So we can write an explicit rule. F of n equals 3 fifths n plus 1. Because we're starting at 1, and we're adding 3 fifths n times. And in the next example, example F, if we look at the difference, this is plus 1, and then plus 3, and then plus 5, so it's not arithmetic, there's nothing that's being multiplied that's going to work every time, so it's not geometric. So this is a case of neither. And because it's neither, it's actually a type of function you'll learn about in a later unit. So that makes the remaining parts of this problem a challenge that you can choose to take on at this point or not. It's up to you, but you won't be assessed on it or held accountable to understand it until later when we learn about this type of function. Mystery function, we'll call it for now. So finally, finishing off with function g, I can see pretty clearly that 10 divided by 5 is going to be 2, and then 2 divided by 5 is going to be 2/5. So dividing by 5 for geometric sequences, because multiplication and division is geometric, we always want to think about what's the equivalent multiplication. Dividing by 5 is the same as multiplying times 1/5. So I can instead write times 1/5 instead of divided by 5. And so we can see 2/5 times 1/5 would be 2/25. And then times 1/5 would be 2/125, and on and on. So to find the next term, we just need to multiply by 1/5. So our recursive rule using MVP style notation is going to be f of n equals f of n minus 1 times 1/5. And again, we're starting with the first term, f of 1 being 10. So we know that because of that, when we multiply by 1/5, we're going to need to do it n minus 1 times. So start at 10 and multiply by 1/5 n minus 1 times. That all goes together. And then we can write our explicit rule, f of n equals 10 times 1/5 to the n minus 1 power. And again, we said this was geometric. Thanks for watching. Hope that helps you with this task. And if you need help with the Ready, Set, Go problems, please check out the Ready, Set, Go student support site in Canvas.